Hello, everyone, and good afternoon. My name is Shirish Jajodia. I lead the Treasury, Investor Relations, and Capital Markets functions at MicroStrategy. Today, I'll be talking about what MicroStrategy has been able to achieve with its Bitcoin strategy, and what are the other type of corporates that can benefit by following a similar path and turning around their business and can benefit from Bitcoin. So to begin with MicroStrategy, we have a dual corporate strategy. There's a balance sheet strategy, which is what we are well known for, the Bitcoin side, and there's an operating strategy. Starting on the operating side, the company is the leading AI-powered enterprise analytics software company. We have been publicly listed for over 25 years. The company generates $500 million in annual revenue, 60 to 80 million of free cash flow, and that's kind of the operating side of the business that generates revenue, pays the costs, pays the bills. And now there's a balance sheet side of the strategy, which is the Bitcoin strategy. MicroStrategy is the largest publicly listed corporate holder of Bitcoin in the world and the first public company to adopt Bitcoin as its primary treasury reserve asset. As of today, the company holds 226,331 Bitcoin, which is more than 1% of the circulation, all the Bitcoin that will ever be in circulation, at an average price of roughly $37,000. The company has invested over $8 billion in cost basis, and the treasury is currently worth over $15 billion. So to give a snapshot of the before and after of MicroStrategy, going back to August of 2020, when the company first adopted its Bitcoin strategy, the company held no Bitcoin. The treasury was 100% cash. The company was holding around $500 million of cash on balance sheet. The market cap of the company was $1.2 billion. Enterprise value was $700 million. And the share price was close to $120. And the share price was pretty flat for a while, for a couple of years. And there was very thin liquidity in the stock. It was trading like 40,000 shares, close to like $5 million on a daily basis. Fast forward to today, the company holds 226,000 Bitcoins. The market cap is close to $38 billion on a fully diluted basis, which is an annual return of 140% annually over the last 4 years. And enterprise value of $40 billion, annualized return of over 180%, and the share price close to $1,800. And it fluctuates by $100 on any given day when we're looking at it. It's close to $1,750, $1,760 today. And that's a return of 97% annualized over the last 4 years. The difference between the share price and the market cap growth is the premium that the market is attributing to MicroStrategy for being the only pure play and operating company with such Bitcoin exposure. And the difference in the enterprise value growth is the capitalization of the company that we have been able to achieve by taking on more debt, more capital to grow the Bitcoin strategy. To show the performance of MicroStrategy over the last 4 years since we adopted the strategy versus now, we have outperformed all the key assets and indices, including Bitcoin itself, and most of the big tech stocks, including NVIDIA. So the key numbers to note here is Bitcoin's performance, annualized basis, is close to 50% annual returns. And the S&P returns, if you look at it on an annualized basis, it's roughly around 12 to 13%. So when you think about the companies that are kind of holding cash on their balance sheet, making like 5% returns on money market currently, which is kind of the peak of their interest rates, the cost of capital is actually the return of S&P 500. They should be generating at least that much, 12, 13% return. And anything less than that is kind of dilutive to the shareholders. What are the type of institutions that are holding Bitcoin? ETFs currently hold around 1.1 million Bitcoin as of yesterday. Countries hold 500,000 Bitcoins. So this is sometimes not well known. United States holds over 200,000 Bitcoin. China holds over 200,000, close to 200,000 Bitcoin. Ukraine and some other countries hold Bitcoin. There are a bunch of private companies holding 500,000 Bitcoins. Public companies, excluding miners, hold over 300,000 Bitcoin, and majority of which, two-thirds of which, is held by MicroStrategy. And there are over a dozen mining companies today that hold over 50,000 Bitcoin. Marathon yesterday announced their full HODL strategy, and they bought $100 million of Bitcoin, and they will be investing more in Bitcoin going forward. So that's a great move by Marathon, and we expect more miners to follow suit. So combined, that's like 12% of Bitcoin in circulation held by all these big institutions. Why should corporations feel more comfortable today looking at Bitcoin? Is because there is significantly more regulatory clarity than what we had 4 years ago. You know, the approval of the spot Bitcoin products in the US and internationally has given a lot of, you know, regulatory comfort and clarity to the traditional finance institutions. And comparing 4 years ago versus today, there's, you know, more acceptance among the investment bankers about Bitcoin to be able to work on Bitcoin. That wasn't the case 4 years ago. There's more high quality research content available from Fidelity and other institutions. And that wasn't the case 4 years ago. And there's support from institutions like BlackRock, Fidelity, you know, Bitwise, Arc, all these into Bitcoin. On accounting side, the treatment was kind of intangible accounting, which was not a favorable treatment. It was okay for a company like MicroStrategy because we are fully invested into Bitcoin and our investors understand it. But for a corporation that is looking to adopt 10% or 20% of their treasury into Bitcoin, for them, it was a little bit unfavorable. And getting the fair value treatment on accounting makes it easier for corporates to be able to adopt a small portion of their treasury if they'd like to turn to Bitcoin. And the macro environment where we stand currently, the sovereign debt levels are at all-time high, and central banks have not much choice but to debase their currencies to kind of get out of it. So if you look at the universe of all the public companies in U.S., currently, U.S. publicly listed companies hold $3 trillion in cash and short-term investments. And that's just melting away. Assuming they invest in money market, that's earning them 5% return at best. And if they hold it just on their balance sheet without investing, that's just losing value. And I'll go back to the return of S&P 500. That's kind of the cost of capital benchmark. They need to generate at least 12% return, 12 or 13%. If they are generating below that, they're kind of diluting the shareholder value. So is there a possibility? Is there any other asset where companies can generate more return? Bitcoin, over the last 4 years, had ARR of over 50%. And as more adoption grows, on the conservative side, it can be expected to have 20 to 30% return, if not more, going forward, looking at the adoption trajectory. So just running some numbers here, if the companies turn even 5% of their treasury into Bitcoin, that results in like $150 billion of investment, and that's like 10x of MicroStrategy treasury. Now, running some other scenarios, what are the type of companies that can benefit from adopting a similar strategy? If you look at the publicly listed companies in the US over a certain market cap threshold, there are like 5,000 companies. If you look at the high cash and low debt companies, the companies that are holding a lot of cash and debt less than one times or two times their net debt to EBITDA, and they are low growth or declining revenue company. And when I say that, that means like 0 to 5% growth over the last 3 years or even negative growth. What are the options for these companies? If these companies, if you filter down from 5,000 to 1,000 to 250, those 250 companies, if they reach out to investment bankers and go to Goldman or Morgan Stanley or any bankers, like, please help us. The solution that they're going to hear is you need to do a transformational deal. Either you got to sell yourself or you got to buy something that will give you 20% return. And that is expensive. And what are you going to buy that's giving you 20% return? Bitcoin is a universal merger partner for these companies. And if you look at the universe of such companies, MicroStrategy was one such company that adopted this strategy, and we saw the results of what we have been able to achieve. What are the other companies? GameStop is sitting on a lot of cash from their equity issuance, can benefit from such strategy. eBay, Cisco, they have very high cash, low debt, and they are kind of low growth, declining revenue companies. Best Buy, Teradyne, you know, some of the well-known names here fall in that universe. And these are the companies where the treasurers, CFOs, CEOs, they have a fiduciary responsibility to learn about Bitcoin, and they can't keep on ignoring anymore, and they got to learn and look at this alternative and what we have been able to do and what they can, how they can benefit from such strategy. Now, if you look at the companies that have increasing revenue, that comes to around 750 companies in this universe, and they can benefit. While all companies can benefit, these companies have increasing revenue while also sitting on a bunch of cash and low debt. And if you look at the universe of those companies, Semler Scientific just adopted the Bitcoin strategy. Tesla has some Bitcoins. Other companies, Apple, Microsoft, Nvidia, Meta, Amazon, Costco. Costco is a high growth revenue company and also very cash rich and low debt. They can very well benefit. Berkshire Hathaway, you know, Google. So these are the companies that have a ton of cash and they're mega cap. And while it's more difficult for mega cap companies to move nimbly, the smaller or mid-sized companies, they are going to need this even more. And we are going to see adoption like we saw from Semler. And we'll see from more companies in different sectors follow similar strategy. Now, other question that corporate treasurers think about is, like, if they don't know what to do with the cash, just return it back to the shareholders. And the way to return it back to the shareholders is either by paying dividends or by performing buybacks. Dividend is a way to just give the cash back to the shareholders and let them decide on how to get better returns than the company itself. Or say if a corporate has a great quarter, they performed very well, the stock price went up. Now every following quarter, they have a pressure to perform better and better. And the way they do it is they can do it by buybacks and by kind of inflating the stock price by reducing the share count. So if you look at over the last 4 years since COVID and since MicroStrategy adopted its Bitcoin strategy, $5 trillion have been returned to shareholders in dividends and buybacks. That's a staggering number. And even a small proportion of that, if directed towards Bitcoin, can generate very high value for all these corporates. If you just look at last quarter itself in Q1 this year, S&P 500 companies returned over $230 billion to shareholders via buybacks. The top 20 buybacks in the US accounted for $120 billion. That's 8 times MicroStrategy Treasury. Apple, Meta, all the big tech companies you see, they have been doing heavy buybacks to prop up the share price and just returning the value back to the shareholders. This is like decapitalizing the company. And while adopting a Bitcoin strategy, they can capitalize the capital structure even further. Now, we talked about the sources of cash, like the cash investment into Bitcoin. There are other sources. Once the company invests their cash, they can also tap the capital markets, and that's like the next gear to tap the debt markets, equity markets, to adopt a bit, to acquire more Bitcoin. And MicroStrategy has been able to, you know, activate all gears. We have invested $800 million of our cash from the initial treasury, from the cash flows over the last 4 years, issued over $4 billion of debt. Our blended cost of debt is 1.6%. Long-term maturity so that it doesn't impact, doesn't get impacted by the volatility of Bitcoin. Our average debt maturity, weighted average is 5.2 years. And issue more equity, which is anti-dilutive. As there is, you know, more liquidity, there's more, you know, demand in the stock, you can issue equity, and that helps accrete more Bitcoin in an anti-dilutive fashion. So the benefits of adopting the Bitcoin strategy for the corporates is they get the benefit of beating the cost of capital and getting the benefit of the appreciation of the hardest asset, Bitcoin gives the best brand visibility. You know, as Semler adopted Bitcoin and other companies do, they get more attention, they get more traction. That improved the stock liquidity. MicroStrategy stock pre-Bitcoin was trading $5 million of shares per day. Now it trades $2.5 billion. That's like multiple 100x on the trading. And more volatile the stock with Bitcoin, there's more trading volume. As there's more trading volume in equity, the option markets comes to life. It enables more low-cost borrowing, and all these options get activated. And there'll be an advantage for the companies. It's a race, so like whoever gets it first is gonna benefit more than the rest. How can companies go about it? They need to identify the Bitcoin champions and the company. Need to get the right management and board buy-in, and that's a key step from a governance perspective. Establish the right internal policies and protocols and get the audit controls in place from a legal perspective, accounting perspective, tax perspective, and get everything in place. And partner with institutional-grade exchanges and custodians if they're planning to buy Bitcoin on the Treasury. Companies can also buy the ETF products. However, those are securities, and the companies are limited by how much they can buy. I think it's capped at 40%. But if they're buying Bitcoin, they can. It's a commodity, so they can buy more, and they can invest up to their full treasury or activate the other gears from capital markets to invest into Bitcoin, and then execute with laser focus. For other companies, they don't have to go through all the struggle that MicroStrategy has to go through over the 4 years. For others, we have put together all the resources. Bitcoin is hope, so hope.com is a resource where you'll find all these resources, all the educational materials about how corporates can learn about Bitcoin, can educate their management and board, and to execute the strategy. We are big advocates for Bitcoin for corporations, and we hold this conference annually, and we have put out our playbook. We have open sourced it for other corporates, how they can put these policies in place and how they can step by step execute. And also, we just announced yesterday a partnership with Bitcoin Magazine to accelerate the corporate adoption of Bitcoin by bringing these, by putting all the resources in one umbrella and offering that to other corporates so that they can they can easily, you know, find all the resources in one place and help them come up to speed on the Bitcoin treasury side. So, as the sentiment moves from the fear of doing something to the fear of not doing something, we'll see more and more companies adopting Bitcoin. There will only be 21 million Bitcoin, and there'll be a race from 5 companies, 10 companies, then hundreds of companies following the similar strategy. And as Michael Saylor says, Bitcoin is a shining city in cyberspace. 21 million Bitcoin, that's 276 cube. So that's the block space available for everyone. And the sooner you get in there, the more the benefit you can take. Thank you.